So, you know, I spent the last few months trying to figure out what I could say, because my sisters said they couldn't do this, so they anointed me to do it. Thanks.
You're the oldest.
I'm the oldest. Yeah. And I'm telling you that. And I am old. So, you know, I finally came up with something. And it really, to me, it's all about thanking my mom for everything that she did and what she meant to me, to her friends, to her family, to her coworkers. I feel like I wanted to say thank you. So, you know, one of the things that really meant a lot to me was, you know, I want to thank my mom for all of her caring advice. Okay, so she always tried to keep us safe and keep us out of trouble. You know, some of my sisters didn't always, you know. Her son was, you know, the angel. But there is one instance, you know, I remember, and some of you know this story, but there was a prom, a winter formal, actually, and I was taking my girlfriend at the time to winter formal, and my mom, you know, as we're getting ready to leave the house, she said, "Now, don't go parking anywhere." And then, like, it was 40 degrees below zero in blizzard weather. And I'm like, "Oh my God, Mom, stop." Well, so we're taking a little drive through Moonville Park, which is a beautiful little park by the river. And I'm driving my big old 70 Chevy, and we're cruising around, and I turn a corner, and I see this great big snowdrift over the thing. I'm like, "I got this. I gunned to go through." Yeah, no. So I had to walk a couple blocks away to the house to call home, hoping that Dad would answer. So I'm like, "Oh my God." And Mom answered. She's like, "What's wrong?" I'm like, "Can I talk to Dad?" What's wrong? "I really need to talk to Dad." "You're in a snowdrift, aren't you?" "Did you go parking?" "No, actually, I didn't." So we ended up, my girlfriend and I, my wife now, we got a ride to Spash to go to the dance. Her roses were black, frozen. And worst of all, we had to get a ride home with Cindy and her boyfriend at the time. Which he was not pleased. So that was one of my favorite stories my mom used to tell everybody. But you know, she was always trying to look out for us. So so the next thing, one of the things that she really instilled in me, and probably a lot of you, is that, you know, the values that she taught and by example, right? To me, she always showed respect to everybody, and she taught us the value of respect. Respect your elders, respect people you work with, and, you know, always do the right thing, right? She valued love, family, and family meant something much more global than most of us think. For her, family was all of her friends, all of her coworkers, her kids, her grandkids, everybody, right? So. She really treated everyone like family, the Trivian family and the Trivian family, right? So, you know, that people meant a lot to her, and she was truly a loving person. I think the other part is that, yeah, she always treated. Sorry. I don't know how Dad lived this. She always treated people with kindness. She always treated others like she wanted to be treated, and she stood up for people who were mistreated, and I think that was always a wonderful thing. One thing she always said to me was, and she talked about it a lot, was that, you know, people can be mean to you, and she always would really overdo it and smile more and be even extra friendly and extra nice to people that were bad to her. And she turned people around and made them into friends instead of enemies. So I think that was, she really, again, she was leading by example and really, she really cared about people. You know, in the end, I think one of the things she talked a lot about was she was worried about things that were happening in the world, but she was always worried about what does this mean for our, for the kids and the grandkids and their kids. So she was always worrying about what was going on in the world and how that, what that meant for our kids' futures. Okay, so another thank you is really around, you know, support and encouragement. She always supported everything that we did, me and my sisters, right? I mean, I think sometimes she wondered why we were doing some of the things we were doing. Wished we hadn't, but she always was there to support us in every way possible, and that was really wonderful. I think, you know, in the end, one of the things that I think I'm really most thankful for, and Dad talked about it, is the time we got to spend together. I was lucky enough to be able to work from my old bed, my old childhood bedroom. Dad calls it the Illinois room now. We tell all the hospice nurses, yeah, Steve is going to work in Illinois, and it's right there in the head. And of course, you know, I was there sometimes to help out Mom because Dad couldn't hear. So she'd be like, Rick! Okay. So I could put my phone call, my conference call on hold, run out there, find Dad or help Mom. But, you know, one of the things that was really wonderful is that all my sisters and I were there practically every day for like 4 months. And, you know, like Dad said, you know, you don't always get the opportunity. A lot of people don't get the opportunity, especially with COVID last year. You know, I had a friend who lost her mom the day before Mom died. And she didn't get to spend any time with her mom because she was in the hospital. Right? So, you know, I really treasure the time we spent together. one of the examples there was that in the last, you know, before Christmas, as we went shopping with Mom, we took her to Walmart, and we spent, I don't know, 4 hours trips
at least
going up and down every aisle. I'm pushing the wheelchair, my back is killing me. Oh my God. And she's got, each of the, my sisters had multiple carts. And she's like throwing stuff in the cart. And then at one point, we were coming down one of the aisles, and I think it was Danielle. Danielle was pushing a cart full of stuff that Mom had put in there. And Mom's like, what is that cart? Mom, that's your stuff. She loved Christmas. I mean, that was, that, you know, for her to make it to Christmas and through Christmas was one of the biggest things for her. And we're so excited to be able to have Christmas. Like Dad said, we truly thought about maybe having it early because we weren't sure, but man, she worked hard to make sure she was there for Christmas, and thank God for that. We had a wonderful Christmas and spent a lot of treasured moments. Some of the other things in the last days, and this is one of the things my sisters and I talked about a couple days ago, is that there was one point in time where we were all huddled around her bed and playing rock and roll music, playing Elvis 60s and 50s music, and it was so special, you know, just, you can't, like Dad said, you've got to make those memories when you can, and that one will live on through my entire life. Also, she loved to cook, and Dad's really probably still struggling with that right now, but, you know, one of the other things we did a lot was cook together, and even when she was in her wheelchair, she was at that kitchen table helping us make tacos. I know we made a fish fry one day, and she was so excited about that. I mean, we had such a good time doing this. So those are the, you know, those are little moments, but we had a lot of those, and I was so thankful for that. Okay. you know, I think the other thing, you know, another thing I'm really thankful for is her as my friend, okay? And I know it sounds kind of weird, she's my mom, but anytime something happy happened in my life, I'm excited, the first thing I want to do is pick up the phone and call her, right? Or I'm struggling with something, you know, pick up the phone and call mom. And she was always a great listener and cared about everything and wanted to help and wanted to reassure her and support. And you know, they're just, now when stuff happens, you know, it's really hard because it's like, you know, it's good news or I'm excited about something and the first thing I want to do is pick up the phone and no, can't. So that keeps hitting me time and time again. But it really makes me, you know, remember how important it was to call mom and to be there and to be with her. So yeah, you know, make those moments today. The other thing I'm thankful for are the memories and stories she always shares, right? She told stories all the time. She could talk for hours and hours. And that's what we did. We're going to revisit. We'd sit in that living room, and we could talk for hours. And sometimes I'd get exhausted out of bed. But she could tell stories, and they were all fascinating and fun. And, well, sometimes she repeated them. But you know, I think we've all had that experience, right? We're sitting in the living room with mom, and that's, you know, we're talking to the TV on, we're just talking, right? And I think that, I think what was important for me too is that she shared memories of things we can't remember, right? She talked about how, you know, when my dad was working late shift at night and I was first born, you know, we'd be sitting and watching Dark Shadows, my mom and I. I can't remember that. She's told me that story so many times, it's like it's there, right? So, you know, I think the last thing that, you know, as I went through pictures and, you know, we scoured through digital pictures and photo albums and you can see a bunch of them here, but as I'm going through there, every time I found one that she's smiling at, it just, you know, it filled my heart with joy. She had that way of giving you that smile that really warmed your heart. And that's that I'm gonna miss. Okay, so real quick, I'm gonna read a little poem. Okay. It's called Farewell, Dear Mother. I'll try to get through it. Somewhere in my heart, beneath all my grief and pain, is a smile I still wear at the sound of your dear name. The precious word is mother. She was my world, you see, but now my heart is breaking because she's no longer here with me. God chose her for his angel to watch me from above, to guide me and advise me, and know that I'm still loved. The day that she had to leave me, when her life on earth was through, God had better plans for her, for this I surely knew. When I think of her kind heart and all those loving years, my memories surround me, and I can't back the tears. She truly was my best friend, someone I could confide in. She always had a tender touch and a warm and gentle grin. I want to thank you, Mother, for teaching me so well. And though the time has come that I must bid you farewell, I'll remember all you've taught me and make you proud, you'll see. Thank you, my dear Mother, for all the love you showed me. Although you've left this earth and now you've taken flight, I know you are here with me each morning, new and late. Thank you.